towards the surface area of Bhoomi, that is right circular Bhoomi. Already we have seen some problems. Some more problems we will see. The problem is a bus stop is barricaded from the remaining part of the road by using 50 hollow cones made of recycled cardboard. Each one has a base diameter of 40 cm and height 1 meter. If the outer side of each of the cones is to be painted and the cost of painting is ₹12 per meter square, what will be the cost of painting all these cones? Okay, two values are given. Pi equals to 3.414 and root 1.04 is equals to 1.0. These two values we have to use. Okay. So first we will see which things are given here. Okay. So one more time I am going to read. A bus stop is barricaded from the remaining part of the road. Okay. By using 50 hollow cones. Okay. How many cones are there? 50 hollow cones made of recycled cardboard. Each one has a base diameter of 40 cm. Base diameter is equal to 40 cm. Okay. And height 1 meter. Height is 1 meter. Understood? Here it is given in centimeter, here it is given in meter. If the outer side of each of the cone is to be painted, outer side of the to be painted, it is given. And the cost of painting is rupees 12 per meter square. Cost of painting is given to be 12 per meter square. What will be the cost of painting all this? Okay, so first, what is given here? Diameter is given. So from diameter, easily we can find out radius. Okay, here what is given? Height is given. Okay, and what they have told us? In the outer side of each of the cones. Outer side of each of the cones. So here we need to think about curved surface. Okay, so we have to find out curved surface area. To find out curved surface area of a cone, right, circular cone, we use formula pi r l. Okay, here part value of pi is given. Radius we can find out with the help of this diameter, but l is not given directly. So l we need to find out first. Okay, so whatever given things are there that I am taking here. So in solution, what is given? Diameter. Base diameter is given. Diameter is equals to 40 centimeters. 40 centimeters. So we can convert this into radius will be 20 centimeters. Radius will be half of this. Okay. But this is given, height is given in meter. So we will convert this into meter. Okay. So radius is equal to 20/100. That is 0.2 meters. So radius will give you 0.2 meters. Okay, what is given? Height is given. Height is equals to h is equals to 1 meter. So that as it is, you will get. Okay, and if the outer side of each of the cones, so here we need to find out curved surface. Okay, so here first we will find out slant. Okay, without slant height we cannot find out curved surface. Okay, so here slant height, you know that l is equals to under root h square plus r square. Okay, we have h also, we have r also. So now I am going to put here values. H is, what is h? 1 meter. Okay, so here 1 square plus r is, what is r? 0.2. Okay, it's square, 0.2 square. So 1 square is 1 plus 0.2 square is 0.04. Okay, so now what we will do? Addition of this will be 1.0. Okay, addition of this will be 1.0. But here it is given 1.04 is equal to 1.02. So directly value became 1.0. So slanting height is 1.0. Okay, now we have slanting height, we have radius, so we can find out CSA. Third surface area of cone. Third surface area of cone is equal to pi r l. Okay, so pi value of pi is given, so that we will take 3.14 multiplied by radius. Radius we have, that is 0.2. So that I am taking here 0.2 multiplied by slant height is 1.02. Okay, so this will be your slant height, so it will be in meter square. Okay, but this is not our final answer. What we have to find out is to be painted. The outer side of each of the poles is to be painted, and the cost of painting is rupees 12 per meter square. Okay, so suppose I have to find out cost of painting, then I need to multiply by 12. But here, how many poles are there? They have told us 50 hollow poles. So here we need to multiply by 12 also and 50 also. So here directly I am taking that. So cost of painting of 50 hollow poles is equal to what? This is earth surface area of one pole. Like that, there are 50 poles. So 3.14 multiplied by 0.2 multiplied by 1.02 multiplied by how many poles are there? There are 50 poles. So we need to multiply by 50, and the cost is rupees 12 per meter square. Okay. So this, the product of this is your answer. That is your answer. So not necessary we have to find out here. Directly we can find out here answer. Okay. So the, this product is rupees 384.50. Okay, so total costing is rupees 384.50. Once again, see here what was given. Diameter was given. With the help of diameter, we have, then we have to find out radius. Radius we need to convert into meters because other dimensions are given in meter. So, with the help of height and radius, we have to find out slant height, because without slant height, we cannot find out curved surface area. Okay, now. Once you get curved surface area, we have to multiply by 50 because 50 poles are there, and the costing is given to be 12 per meter square. So here we have multiplied by 12. So answer is 384.50.
See here, our second problem is a cylinder and a cone have equal radii of their bases and equal heights. If their curved surface areas are in the ratio 8:5, show that the radius of each is to the height of. Hello everybody. See here, our next problem is what length of tarpaulin 3 meter wide will be required to make a conical tent of height 8 meter and base radius 6 meter. Assume that the extra material will be required for stitching margins and wastage in cutting is approximately 20 cm. Okay, so here first we will see what is given. Okay, so what length of tarpaulin 3 meter wide, okay, width is given 3 meter, will be required to make a conical tent of height 8 meter. Height is also given 8 meter, vertical height, this is vertical height. And base radius 6 meter. Radius is also given directly. Okay. Now, assume that the extra material will be required for stitching margins and wastage in cutting is approximately 20 cm. Means this is extra material is required, 20 cm. That we need to add afterwards. Okay, in the final answer. So first, these two statements are important. What length? Here we have to find out length. Okay. Width is given. Understood? So length into width is equal to area, curved surface area we need to find out. Why curved surface area? See, a conical tent, okay, tarpaulin means it will be open from the bottom. So here we are going to find out curved surface area. Okay, to find out curved surface area, we are going to use formula pi r. Okay, but here height is given. Height is given. L is not given directly. L we need to find out. Slant height we need to find out. So height is given and radius is given. Okay. So with the help of these two, we are going to find out slanting height. So what is given height? Height, that is h, is equals to 8 meter. And what is given radius? Radius of the tent, that is small r, is equal to 6 meters. These two things are given. Okay. With the help of these two, we can find out easily slant height. So slant height is equals to under root h square plus r square. Okay, so what is h? H is 8 square plus r is 6 square. Okay, so 8 square is 64 plus 36. So that will be 64 plus 36 will be 100 is equal to 10 meters. Okay, so slant height we have now 10 meters. Understood? Now we have slant height, we have radius, so we can find out easily curved surface area. Then we will come to know how much material is required. How much material is required for 10? Understood? So here we find out curved surface area CSA of 10 or cone also we can say is equal to pi r l. Okay, so what is pi? Pi is given 3.14, so that I am taking here 3.14 multiply by radius. What is the radius? 6 meter multiply by length, slanting height is 10. Okay, so that I am taking here 10. Understood? So when you multiply by 10, that time what will get? 31.4 multiply by 6. So you can find out here final answers. Okay, so curved surface area we got 31.4 multiply by 6. Okay, but now here what is given? Width is given. Width is 3 meter. Width is 3 meter, and we have to find out length. Okay, so we know that length into width is equal to area, curved surface area here. Okay, so directly we can use length is equal to 31.4 multiplied by 6 divided by 3. Okay, so now here 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. So what you will get? 4, 2 fours are 8, 2 ones are 2, and 3 twos are 6. Okay, so 62.8 meters. 62.8 meters. This much, this will be the length of that tarpaulin. Understood? But now here one more thing is given. One more thing is given, that is 20 cm is required. More material is required. So that material we need to add here. Okay. So 62.8 plus 20 cm, that we need to convert into meters. Okay. So 20 cm is equal to 20 cm, 20 by 100 meters. So it will be 0.2 meters. So this 0.2 meters we need to add here. Okay. So final total length. Total length is equal to 62.8 plus 0.2. So that will be 63 meters. 63 meters. So that is your final answer. Once again, see here what was given. What length of tarpaulin 3 meter wide will be required to make a conical tent of height 8 meter, base radius 6 meter. The height was given and radius was given. So with the help of that, we have to find out slant height. With the help of slant height, we have to find out curved surface area, and then curved surface area with the help of this given width, we have to find out length. But one more thing was given, that is more material is required, 20 cm, that is margin. So that we need to convert into meters, and that we have to add. So that is 63 meters. Okay. So this is our final answer. Here we need to take care of units. Okay. Sometimes meters we need to convert into centimeters. Centimeter we need to convert into meters. It is depend on the problem. Thank you. Each as 3:4. Okay. This we have to show. They have told us to show this. Okay. So now here once again I am going to read here. A cylinder and a cone have equal radius. There are two figures. A cylinder and a cone. Two three dimensional figures are there. Cylinder and cone have equal radii of their bases. Equal radii of their bases. Okay. So this is cylinder and this is right circular cone. Right circular cylinder and right circular cone. Okay. What they have told us, their bases, radii of their bases are equal. Okay. Means this radius and this radius of bases are equal. So this suppose we will say r, then here this also small. Okay. Radius, radii are equal. One more thing they have told us, height is also equal. Heights of both the figures are equal. Means this height, suppose I will take this is h, or here also we can say this distance is h. So here height means this is vertical height, this is h, and both heights are equal. Okay, this is given thing. Now what they have told us, if their curved surface areas are in the ratio 8:5, curved surface area of this and curved surface area of this. Okay. Means ratio is given 8:5. Okay. So here we can use curved surface area of cylinder is equal to 2 pi r h. Okay. We use this formula to find out curved surface area of cylinder. Okay. Now second thing, that is also per surface area, or we can write in short CSA also, per surface area of cone is equals to pi r l. Okay, and the ratio of this is given, 2 pi r h and pi r l. The ratio, this ratio is given. So directly I can write here according to the given information, 2 pi r h divided by pi r l. Okay, what is given here, ratio 8:5, so is equal to 8/5 meter. Okay, so now here height pi, value of pi is going to remain same, radius is same of both the figures. Okay, so these two things we can cancel. Now what, these two we can take that side and we can divide. So what is going to remain here, h upon l is equal to 8/5 multiplied by 1/2. Okay, 2/2 here we need to divide. So now here 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8. So what is remaining here, h upon l is equal to 4/5. Okay, so now here we can put here value of l. Okay, what is l? L is the slant height, and slant height is equals to under root h square plus r square. So here I am going to put now. Okay, so h upon value of l is equals to under root h square plus r square. H square plus r square. Slanting height is equals to under root h square. S means h means what? Vertical height, and r is the radius. E is equals to 8/4. Okay, that is going to remain same. Understood? Why we have here we have taken value? Because this l we are going to change in terms of h. Okay, then only we can find out this value. So here we got h upon under root h square plus r square is equal to 4/5. Now I want to cancel this root. So I will take square of both the sides, LHS and RHS. By taking square of both the sides, what I will get here? H square. When I will take square of this, that time I will get here only h square plus r square will remain, is equal to 4 square is 16 upon 5 square is 25. Okay, what we have done here, we have taken square of both the sides, LHS and RHS. So here h square, when you will take square of this, square root will vanish, then here it will remain h square plus r square is equal to 4 square is 16 and 5 square is 25. Now here we can take cross multiplication, so 25 into h square will be 25 h square, 16 into h square plus 16 into r square. Okay, now this h square term you can take this side, then like terms will come together. So now I am taking this here, 25 h square minus 16 h square is equal to 16 r square. Okay, so now here what is going to remain, 25 minus 16, 9 h square is equal to 16 r square. Okay, now what they are asking, they are asking show that the radius of each is to the height of each as 3:4. Okay, so now what we can do here, h square divided by r square, or r square divided by h square also we can take. So now what I am doing here, this 9 upon this 16 I am taking here, divided by 16 is equal to r square upon h square. 9 divided by 16 and r square divided by h square. If I will remove this square, then what I will get, r upon h is equals to what, 3/4. We will take square root of 9 and 16. 9 and 16 are perfect square. So 3/4. So r is to h is equal to 3:4. And that will be they are asking to show. Okay, 3:4. Okay. Once again, we will put a glance here. What was given? A cylinder and a cone have equal radii. Okay, cylinder and a cone have equal radii. So we have taken that is r, base radius of both. We have taken r, small r. And their heights are also equal. So height we have taken h, here also height is h. Then if their curved surface areas are in the ratio 8:5, okay, curved surface, 2 pi r h and pi r l, ratio is given. So we have taken 2 pi r h upon pi r l is equal to 8/5. So pi r we can cancel, what is remaining here, h by l is equal to 8/5, by this 2 we can divide there. So here it is remaining 4/5. Then we have taken value of l. L is the slanting height. Slanting height is equal to the under root h square plus r square is equal to 4/5. Now we need to cancel this square. square root. So we have to take square of both the sides, LHS and RHS. So H square divided by H square plus R square is equal to 16 upon 25. By cross multiplication, you will get here 9 H square is equal to 16 H R square, and we have to show here 3 is to 4. Okay, radius is to height. So we have taken 9 by 16 is equal to R square upon H square. When you will remove the square, that time